I'm Chris Edwards. Welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. Now, last week we went over how to add power to your racket. This week we're going to do the opposite and how we're going to add control to the racket. First and easiest thing to do is on your next restring is just bump up the tension a few pounds. A higher tension is going to firm up the string bed and it's going to make the racket play with more control. So the ball is going to come into the string bed with a firmer string bed, tighter string. It's going to flatten out. You're going to take some of the energy out of the ball, and then it's not going to fly with as much height or as much depth as it would with a lower strung racket. So you can bump the tension up. Now, each racket will come with a recommended tension range. I really recommend you kind of adhere to that. It's a good guide. And you want to, you know, go from the midpoint on. So looking at a racket like this, the tension range is going to be right in the throat. And say on your racket it's 50 to 60 pounds. If you're stringing around mid 55, whatever, and you're still getting a bit too much flight on the ball, maybe you're struggling to control approach shots or passing shots, just feel like the ball is flying on you a little bit, try bumping up to 57 pounds, and then you can just gradually work your way up and get more and more control out of the racket that way. So tension, simple and easy thing to do, and you can just stay with the string. If you like the string you're using and you like the racket you're using, just want a little bit more control, great way to add just a little bit of control right there. Now, if you're using even a powerful string in your racket and you want to increase the control, check out what gauge of string you're using. Gauge of string is going to refers to the thickness of the string. So if you're using like a 16 or a 17 gauge or even an 18 gauge, 18 gauge is very thin, 17 a little thicker, 16 thicker still. If you really want to up the control, you want to be looking at, say, 16 gauge or even thicker than that. And this is a 15L, so it's a 15 light. And this string is 1.35 millimeters, so it's a nice thick string. And even though this is natural gut, this is Clip Legend natural gut, great playing natural gut, very powerful string. But again, if you put it in a thicker gauge, and also if you bump the tension up a little bit, you're going to get a ton of control out of just this string right here, even though it's got great power properties to it too. Just that thicker gauge is going to have you more control to your game. The other thing you can do is switch to a firmer playing string. Polys or copolyester strings are really, really popular right now. Pretty much the entire Pro Tour is using them either in a full bed or in a hybrid with something like natural gut to add a little bit more pop and comfort to the string bed. But here I have one of my favorites. This is Vocal Cyclone. I've been using this string for a really long time and I just love it. It's a great kind of middle of the road poly. Offers decent ball pocketing so that it lets the ball sink in nicely on it. But it also offers a ton of control, great access to spin. It's tough to snap it. It's a very durable string, and they find the tension lasts pretty well for a poly. Polys drop tension a little quicker than natural guts and multifilaments typically, but this one holds tension pretty well for a poly. So it's a great option there, and it comes in various gauges. You can go with a thinner gauge and still get great control out of a poly because it is such a stiff material. So you're getting that firmness in the string bed you want just right out of the string choice. So I can string this in the low 50s in a lot of different rackets and still get a ton of control. Now, Kevlar strings were, when I was back in college, back in the day, a while ago now, really popular with college players because we're all just trying to hit the felt off the ball and hit it as hard as we could. We needed to keep it on the court. Also, we needed this, something that was going to be durable. And Kevlar kind of strings have kind of fallen out of fashion. This is Crossfire 2 from Ashaway, just because of the prevalence of polys. Polys offer a little bit more forgiveness, but if you're still struggling with control and you've tried polys, this stuff will just make your string bed play very, very firmly and very, very dead. And I have a set of it in here. So these main strings right here are the Kevlar strings, and then the cross strings right there are a softer multifilament string, just to add some comfort to the string bed. And I strung this one down at 45 pounds, so it went very, very low, just because it's such a stiff material. I really just tried to open it up a little bit and make it a little bit more forgiving. Now, the one downside to using a poly or using especially Kevlar is they're very stiff. So once you get outside of the sweet spot, you're going to get a lot more shock. It can be a little unforgiving on the arm. So if you have any arm issues, I would really go up the tension a little bit in a nice comfortable string like natural gut or multifilament in a thicker gauge as opposed to going to poly. They're a little bit unforgiving. And if you're learning the game and you're not finding the sweet spot quite as much, or you just have arm issues or something like that, I'd avoid those stiffer strings and maybe just bump up the tension just a couple of pounds and go with a thicker gauge. That's all I've got for this week. Thank you so much for watching.